Hello, pirates, friends of pirate, friends of price charts, lovers of price charts and price action, and lovers of colors, lines, shapes, and you know, lovers of life. Lovers of life, join as we look at price charts of ARRR. BTC and USDT. Yeah, we're looking at price charts. And I'm Idriano, and it's 14th May, 2021, as counted by the humans of this Earth, planet Earth. It's a good day for meditating on death. Every day is a good day for meditating on death. It's also a good day to be alive, waking up with a spring for life, the energy and the vitality with whatever you've got and you give it. We are here because we're looking at price charts for one reason or another and listening to my voice because that's the voice being projected to you. What am I thinking here about the pirate chain right now? Well, maybe some downward action is in store, even up until last night. Well, see, here's the thing. The decoupling might be in play, but also might not. And in which case, you know, BTC might just, the R, when I say BTC here, I'm talking, and I'm pointing with my fingers, which you can't see. I'm talking about the R BTC price here chart. None of this is financial advice. And I like to consider it, if you look at it as art. Here, you are seeing, when I say BTC, a lot of times I'm talking about this chart here. Oh, also in a previous video, I called this, you see the green and the red lines, I called that a flat pattern. I literally use those words, and that's not, that actually means a specific thing, a flat pattern being, you know, something like that, or something like that with variations in the length. Okay. It could be, it might not be, I don't know what but I just use those words. And I do think that it's important to have the proper language. I don't want to be confusing anybody because that's not what I meant. I just meant more like a sideways channel, really. So I should choose my words more carefully. And then we can see if it does develop into a flat, but that's the BTC chart for R. I wanted to first look at this idea of long-term and then very long-term, medium-term, short-term, very short-term, because I started looking at things. I even looked at a couple of other charts, including the ADA BTC chart, and I'm seeing that there is some divergence potentially building with the RSI and the price, and it's fine. It could be just for a short-term down, but and that's kind of what I'm thinking and seeing. For the first time, starting to see in play the potential for the side cloud there, but we'll get into that in a moment. So I started thinking, okay, long-term, I'll call that 5 to 15 years. Very long-term is like 25 plus years. That's basically the most we want to think. And if I'm going to talk very long-term, that's like 25 plus years. If I say long-term, it's like 5 to 15 years. You take a couple of long-terms, you know, depending how many groups of long-terms, it could be like 5 long-terms or even just 2 long-terms, you get a very long-term. Medium term, I'll say, is about 1 to 5 years. So if we're talking about this price chart in the medium term, I'm talking like 1 to 5 years. The short term would be 1 month to 1 year. And depending on the chart time frame, let's say it's the daily chart, then that might relatively change things. So daily chart, a short term might be, you know, 1 week. And the long term for a daily chart might be a year. You know, I won't say make things like very short and very long when we're dealing with a day chart. These are just terms for overall life and overall the life of the chart. All right. So here we are. And yeah, like very short term would be a day to a month, really. So in the very short term, we're looking for some downturn to potentially, now it is in the BTC chart, maybe different in the dollar chart, maybe a bit different. I'm using getaurox. Let's get right into it. if you're still watching, maybe you're using 1.5x speed and you've gotten here faster than others, maybe even 1.75x speed, in which case you're going very fast compared to others. Anyhow, okay, so these trend lines are starting to come into play and making a bit of a triangular shape. And so this is what's leading me. If we point the triangle, so we're on a daily chart. If we start pointing this triangle, we had a nice strength. Okay, good. That's very good. Instead of staying down here and rounding down here, that's might have been fine too. Good. We had some volatility with a strength up, but see all this selling power up here. Before we had all the nice rounded buying power down here. Now we're showing where the selling power is, and it's here, and it's in this sloping trend. Look, another, and see, so now I started coming in. I'm like, okay. In fact, I started with the BTC chart, but whatever. Let's just use the USDT chart here for now, because that's where we are. None of this is scripted, and none of this is advice of any kind of financial ways. But you take what you will. You know, we're here just to be the company of good company, and just learning and growing and figuring things out and watching it happen as it unfolds. So yes, we're above the 20-day average. However, we are showing this indecision candle. It's along with it's red. It's along with this sloping downward. Yes, beautiful. There still is good buying strength. So we don't know, but at any turn of a market, yeah, it could just downturn. And then 5-7 a week later, we're down here. Look, today is May 14. 1 week later is May 21. We're down here. So that's fine. No problem. We go through here. Nice thin cloud up here. We can make it at some point within June. It wouldn't take many days. Look at these candles right here. One candle here, one candle here. Not saying we would have to do it that way either, because that might be too volatile. We don't know how it'll play out, but what's starting to look like here is this uptrending yellow, this downtrending red, forming some sort of triangular form. You see this here, I'm gonna color the last part of it bluish now. See this bluish line? That's part of this other zigging zag that I charted from the line chart. And actually it came from the weekly chart. So that's what started also me thinking, because what I did was looked at the week chart. I don't know why it was on the week chart, but I looked at this RSI and I thought, okay, we are above the normal zone, which is between the bands here. We are much in the overbought zone. Yes, we are lower than the previous high overbought zone, but okay, which means good chance of over time. Let's see, here's 17th of May, 24th of May, here's June. By here, maybe having cleared it out, which means there has to be some associated sideways and or most likely down movement associated with it. We very well could stay up here, but the way the market is playing out, we're not sure. Definitely at this time, not sure. And so money might get cycled around. Who knows? Who knows how these markets are really playing? It's definitely not me. Who knows? But who's on first? I don't know. So this is where I got this. See, this actually was not there. This is the actual market movement here. Okay, you see how it's, this is our actual market movement. This is what we've done so far in these weeks since April 19, correction week. Okay, April 26 week, May 3 week. So May 3 week, we're closing at about $6. So this is our close. We, if zigging and zagging, we have not on a weekly closed at the $5 level. My thinking is that's where we're going. Basically, that's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking that this is going to somehow play out like that in a zigzag pattern. We'll get a simple zigzag pattern at least first. And interestingly enough, and it may or may not look exactly along these type of lines, but it's fair enough to think of it like this. Interestingly enough, when we go to the daily chart, that brings us right through here to the side, roughly, you know. And yeah, so this is the idea. It could be down here. It could be a little more sideways. We could hang this $7 level the whole way through and still have the RSIs be cleaner. On a daily level, we're good here. we're good. And in fact, who knows what kind of movement this might make. Best, if everything is going down on the weekly, best to get this as far down on the daily as we can without hurting the price too much. Well, let's say we'd be looking, let's say for, we go previously. Yeah, you know what, even down here, why not 40 from 50, from 55 to 40 can be done. And that would be a nice shakedown. And then even down further, down to a 35, sure. And then by that point, you know what, I don't know when was the last time it was there, not on this chart. So bring us down here on the daily. You know what, I'm sorry if I'm creating bad voodoo juju here, but here we go. Like whatever's gonna happen is gonna happen. Have yourself set. If you're not feeling safe, take part of your position out. Again, not advice, but this is how we're playing. Like we're doing paper positions, right? We're playing. So to switch it out into either the dollar form USDT or into the BTC form. I know what my preference is, but anyway. Okay, so that's the idea. And if it's interests you, I think that it's interesting that our first move also was one of these type of zigzag patterns. Okay, I'm just rough with it. You see how we made that ziggy zaggy pattern? And obviously a much steeper level and a smaller scale. Here we have it on a weekly level in terms of how it worked. Yeah, this is interesting to me. And so I hope that finds you interested. That would also probably bring us down to this level of the Bollinger Band. My fear would be further breakdown of that Bollinger Band. And that would bring us back into that $4, $3 play. But I don't know. I don't think so. I think that would really clear out this whole move so nicely and set us up for a future move. I like that idea. I just like this idea. I think that now showing what the overall market is doing with Bitcoin, you know, struggling at the 50,000, which is struggling is a strong word because you know what? It's been holding a strong price. This is a massive price. $50,000 of Bitcoin. That's incredible. So that's good. Overall, everything is healthy in my opinion and my beliefs. But right now in the roughly short term here, within the next like 2 to 4 weeks, we are going to see some interesting play action. All right. Oh, and that's also what I wanted to mention was that the time. Yes, the time. So not just price, but time. We've done the fib retracements so much. This is like a roughly a 618 retracement level. That would be a nice. Okay. Now here's the other thing. So not the fib time, just the dates. So if we take our retracement dates and we go, so right now today, in fact, yesterday we were at the 20 bar halfway where previously we had checked out what 40 bars would look like. And that would be over here, the 2nd of June. And then we had looked at what 30 bars might look like. And that will be over here on 23rd May, roughly here, okay? So let's take a look what happens. This is the USDTR chart. And let's see if the BTC one spells a similar type of information or if it gives a slightly different picture. Oh, I wanted to show also, I don't think we looked at it. So on the weekly even, the MACD doesn't have enough information to populate. That RSI you saw on the weekly was very little. So yeah, here we are getting a rounding back up. We're getting closer together here. So who knows where it's gonna settle, but it likely will give us a more full downward movement, I'm guessing, give us some more downward, some differential between, increased differential between these two. Clear this out, the histogram, back to a neutral line, and then boom, we go higher. That's just gonna how it's be, especially on the USD chart, because that's gonna follow Bitcoin better than the Bitcoin chart. Now, this is our other puppy right here. Look at all that movement. All right. The shores over here, and then this massive tsunami wave. Mm-hmm. All right, so in this chart, it looks, it's similar, but slightly stronger. Interestingly though, the 20 period, so 20 day average is much more on the downtrend, or at least it looks like that because the BTC price in R went actually higher before starting to come down. The other one struggled here, the USD price struggled around the 20 day. And so here we have an opportunity actually. So this is what we really need to watch on the BTC chart. We have this opportunity here which is roughly here. You see this previous high that that it's on. And if you look to the left, just before May, right here, you see it there too. So now we're looking, we must support this. If we don't support this, boom, at least we're most likely coming down to the 11,000, but yeah, 10,000 is in play for sure. And in that case, well, we could take a look at the weekly, but BTC chart could be, again, like we said, if Bitcoin is just roaring, yeah, you know what, maybe from 14,000 to 10,000 and going up in USD and kind of having to slide down in BTC, this could easily play out that way as well. No, we don't know, but that's why this level here, this peach level here is going to really spell a lot out for us in terms of where this is going to go. And we haven't yet really put on an indicator such as RSI for the BTC chart. We're just going to check that out, see if we have one of those here. RSI, just take the regular one there. Just take a quick look. So there you go. You know what? Interestingly, so in the daily, again, we're kind of flat here. Let's, before I say interestingly one more time, and you have to take another shot. Yeah, see, similar kind of move, but this one looks slightly more reasonable, as in it doesn't have as far to go to come down to be back in the non-overbought territory. Not that that means anything, but that just, it says something. It's just slightly different chart. We are slightly different. Even here, wow, I'm interested to see this retracement after this plays out. Once this week closes, if this week closes, this 10th week May closes in a certain level, that could definitely be a flat pattern. Let's take a look here, what we're looking at. I just want to find out here by using this Fibonacci. So we would consider the top to the bottom, the wave A. So if we go here to here, yeah, we would have to actually on the BTC level be closing above roughly. So let's say if we close at about 15,500 on the weekly, that would actually signal a normal flat pattern potentially forming here. But if we close above the 61.8, and below the 81, which we are potentially going to do. Today is a Friday technically, and that leaves a couple more days if we can, but this would be such a weak flat pattern. So the BTC price would have to show a bit more strength into this region here between 618 and 81. And that would give us a flat pattern potentially forming. If not, then if it's below the 618, then we're more likely looking at a zigzag if that's the overall correction, which it is. We're looking at more simple lines, which is beautiful. This allows us to draw out the more simple patterns and see them and recognize them and learn about them. So if you're not familiar with patterns, these are, I guess, considered Elliott wave patterns. And Elliott wave patterns are, you can look them up, but there are correction patterns and there are impulse patterns. And you might be familiar with an impulse pattern, you might be familiar with correction patterns. If you're not, check them out. There are very few of them. There's just the impulse pattern. And then correctively, there's flats, zigzags, triangles, and then you can complexify them and have X waves and other things like that. But we're not going there right now. Because yeah, this is even stuff. I'm still learning too. We're all learning and growing here. And if you're still with me watching this, thank you. Keep liking the videos and making those comments and enjoying this pirate journey, okay? So that's basically the thought on the BTC. I guess I'm curious, see, I said it again. And when I said the BTC, I meant the RBTC price. I am curious on the weekly here with the dollar. Somebody was asking for longer videos, so that's for you. This one's for you, my friends. Those of you who actually want it to be longer. Sorry, don't get me wrong. I love it and I enjoy it. But hey, if this isn't for you, where is my dollar price now? What is going on? Yeah, we're way up here. But now where are we? 2023? No, thank you. Too far. What is happening now? Am I missing something? Maybe I am. What has just happened? Let's open it back up. There we go. Thank you. Patience. Thank you everyone for your patience. this was the RUSDT 1 week, and I was saying, hey, let us just quickly look at the same kind of level. Like, I just want to see now, because it gave me the idea. Oh, are we very similar still to the Bitcoin chart? And it does look like we are. It does look like we are. Seems like we're still playing out very much similarly. Yeah. Seems like we are very much playing out similarly. And we're going to do the same thing. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, we're roughly the same, but you could see how the BTC is showing just a bit more strength by being on the other side of the 618 line. But anyway, whatever. It is what it is right now. Okay, I'm glad that I checked that, because now we see. And also, you got, those of you who wanted a longer video got a bit of a longer video, because you know what? We're still not 100% done with that BTC chart. And you know what I mean when I say BTC chart. So here we are looking more. We're going to just dive in a little closer, okay? We're first going to get rid of this sucker. All right, a nice Friday video for those of you just chilling and maybe enjoying the end of some hard effort. What is going on? Okay, when your delete button doesn't work, you better hope it's Friday. So you can just put that ish behind you. Here we go, day, boom. Okay. So daily on the BTC chart, we see how we are higher. Can we get finally rid of you? Maybe. Did I like somehow lock it or something? I probably pressed a button that locked it. Nope. Okay. Now, yeah, we hit that ceiling there. Okay, we're coming down. We have this peach line. That is our roughly 13,500 level, okay? If it breaches that significantly, you might consider getting out and waiting for a better level. Because from here, from this line, what I hadn't said until now, which I started saying, and then I tailed off into all kinds of other things, is that the most likely move from there, if breaking that line. Yes, we could stop at the red line, but I mean, why not? Why not? It would probably go there. Or if not there, in fact, fine. Maybe not the red line even, but maybe here there's good support. Like at that point, we'd start looking at the candles. And yeah, we could start saying here we would get choppy. So in this zone between the 11,500 and the 10,000, which has all previously been a lot of action. And I wouldn't be surprised if there's more strong buying action here down here as well. We'll see. We'll see. But definitely stay with us on this one, okay? And have yourself set up for whatever's to come. Okay. All right, friends, take care of yourselves. That's it for now. I don't really feel like going hard into any closer details, because even like, look on the daily candle here. Yes, we're about halfway through the day, but it's showing weakness. This is a weakness here. Okay. If by the end of the day, we're showing much more strength and something changes, we'll definitely come back with more. But other than that, yeah, just enjoy what you can and stay healthy, stay wealthy, stay wise. All right. That's about it for now. Love, peace, happiness. Bye for now.